what a beautiful night we have. Thank you guys for coming out. We are so grateful. My name is Letitia. I'm with 11, and I'll tell you what, we are sure loving some Sarah Johnson, right? Woo! Beautiful voice. Her merch is over there. Go check her out. Visit with her. Also, we are live streaming, so be sure and share that out to all the folks. All kinds of goodies on the street. We're doing something a little bit different this fall. On the Levitt Center up there, if you decide you want to sit up there, we are charging $10. And I'll tell you what, it's because we're going to raise money for more free live music here at the Levitt. So they'll take it, right? We got to raise the money. Anyway, so thank y'all. Just let you know that that's what's happening tonight and tomorrow night. So thank you for being here. I want to also let you know that this coming Thursday on the 21st, the volunteers, you guys are so great, by the way, volunteers, a lot of our event staff and crew, we've got some cards that say, vote for Levitt Arlington for People's Choice. Doesn't cost you anything to vote from 10 to 8. You guys, if we win, we win $10,000 for live free music. Woo! Woo! Let's do it. It's easy. And you know what? If you'll share it out, if every one of us here had 20 people vote, man, we could do it. So I think we can. Next Thursday, we'll actually be celebrating here for North Texas Giving Day. So your other favorite nonprofits besides the Levitt, they'll all be out here hoping to win money and make money that day. And we appreciate the Arlington Tomorrow Foundation for bringing that event, and that'll be Thursday. So anyway, lots of things going on. Be sure and follow us on social media because you'll be seeing it blasting out a lot in the next few days. All right, Josh Hankins, take it away.
Good evening, guys. Thank you so, so very much for being here on a Friday night. The Levitt is a nonprofit organization, and our mission is to bring the community together with free music in downtown Arlington. That takes all of us. So about halfway through the show tonight, there's going to be some volunteers coming around with buckets. We're going to ask you to open your hearts, open your wallets, and give whatever you can give to make the Levitt happen, to keep putting free music on this stage, bringing people together. If you don't have any cash tonight, you can text the words free music to 44321. If you're watching us at home, you can also help us out with the text. We really appreciate it. But it doesn't work if you guys don't come down here and support it. So thank you for being here. Thank you for coming out. And thank you for watching at home. We really, really appreciate you. All right. Now, our feature artist tonight is one of our very, very favorites here at the Levitt. She is an Austin-based singer-songwriter. She's been singing and writing songs since she was 9 years old, and she moved to Austin right out of high school as the lead singer of a rockabilly band. She has long been a favorite with critics, as well as the alt-country and the Americana community. We are so excited to have her back with us tonight. Please give a big downtown Arlington welcome to Kelly Willis.
Woo!
Thank you so much. How y'all doing out there? Man, we got some awesome weather. Thank God it finally broke. All right, guys, this is a song. It was the title track to an EP I made. It's called Fading Fast.
If I ran so far that my life can't follow me, would it keep the world from up and swallowing me? Well, there's so much weigh me down that I can hardly breathe. I don't want to think about it, but I don't want this pain to last. And I'm fading fast. If I didn't look back, change my name.
Thank you so much. All right, y'all, this was a song that was a last-minute addition to my Easy album that I made. You always think you know the important stuff, and then you find that you need two more. Like, you go in all prepared. And so I just threw this one in at the last second, and it's the only one I always play from that record, so you just never know. But somebody broke up with me once, and I thought they did it all wrong, and I wrote this song. Playing guitar tonight. Back on the drums, Joshua Blue. And John Michael Sheff on the bass. All right, well, this is the title track to my most recent solo record, which is just a little country soul tune I wrote called Back Being Blue.
Called me on the phone. He said I ought to know he wasn't there alone. She's back in my baby's arms and I'm back being blue. Back a sign that love is still so strong. After all this time,
you guys, I swear one day I'm going to write a positive love song. But I tried. This one, it's a song called Only You, and I started it as Only You, like this really sweet thing. And then, I don't know, I just gave up. And I turned it around, and I made it Only You. It was just felt more natural to me. Goes like this.
Only you would break your word, blame it on my ears. Swear I don't know what I heard while laughing at my tears. Only you would bring it round, swear you thought I knew. Say it happens all the time, that's just what
many years back, Mark Colley asked me to come sing a guest spot on a thing he was going to film at the Brushy Mountain State Penitentiary, maximum security prison, and he was going to film like a Johnny Cash thing, and I was going to be the chick singer, jumps up for two songs. So I said yes, and I had to give him my songs like way in advance. And I have a habit sometimes of, occasionally I have recorded songs where I thought that they were about something and then later found out that they weren't, they were about something else. And just a couple of times that's happened, and this is one of them where by the time in between I chose this song for him to play at this prison and then we did it, I realized that this song was actually about the electric chair and the death penalty. And the other song I chose was like the sexiest song I do. So it was the worst two songs I could have picked. And I couldn't change them because his band had learned them. But I think it was okay because I don't think they had seen a woman in a long time. I don't think they were listening. Anyway, this was written by my friend Damon Bramlett.
1, 2, 3, 4. Nobody knows how it felt to see the cannonball melt in your mind.
Thank you. Well, you guys, it's a weird thing to say, but next year this song, it's the title track to an album that turns 25, which I hate being able to say that, but I am trying. I'm working right now on getting it reissued, and I plan on having it re-released next year within a LP form and maybe with some bonus material on it, and do a little tour behind that. Yeah, thanks. But this is a song I wrote with Gary Louris from the Jayhawks after my Nashville years were ending and I didn't know what I was going to do next. And it's called What I Deserve.
Na 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 na, na 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 na, na 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 na, na 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 na.
Thank you very much. All right, well, I went way back for this next one. This was This was on my first record, and it was actually my first single back in 1990. I know. I really was just a little puppy back then, y'all. But, we didn't have a radio in the house back then, and the first time this song got played on the radio, someone had called me, and I ran out to the car and turned it on and listened to it and danced in the front yard. I remember thinking, oh my God, we're gonna be the next Beatles. Yeah, well, didn't work out that way, but I still like this old song. Have not been playing for a long time. I just never had space for it in the show, and I don't know why I do all of a sudden, but but this is a song off that What I Deserve record, another one that I wrote with Gary Louris.
I don't have a chance to go.
Thank you very much. All right, well, I wrote this song after I had a night off out on the road, and we went to the club we were going to play the next night, and a man flirted with me all night. He would not take no for an answer. And it was actually really delightful because it had been a while, y'all. And he didn't know I had all these babies at home or that my husband was 6'8". He didn't know any of that stuff. And it was just delightful. And I thought I'd write a song about the sort of magical thing about flirting. It's called Fool's Paradise. Some sweet promise of love in that look in your eyes, and all that effortless charm could harm the unwise. In a fool's paradise, fool's paradise, a fool's paradise, fool's paradise, fool's paradise. Now I'm not writing this down. You could tell me again if you come back. In a fool's paradise, fool's paradise, a fool's paradise, a fool's paradise, a fool's, a fool's paradise, a fool's paradise, a fool's paradise. So much. Well, this song was a big old hit for the Kindles back in 1977, I'm told. I just have to take their word for it. I don't know how I would know something like that. Goes like this. Deep. Thank you so much. Well, all right, y'all. This song was on my What I Deserve record, and but it was never a single. But I'll tell you, I started noticing when we were traveling and playing it that about halfway through the song, it would sort of lift the crowd. And you don't see that happen a whole lot, but I just noticed that this song had something about it. And Bruce Robinson wrote this song, and the first time I heard it, I was sitting in the Continental Club with Charlie Robinson, and the two of us were at the bar, and Bruce was on stage, and he starts singing this song, and he gets through the first chorus, and Charlie and I turn to each other, and we go at the same time, "I'm recording this song." And there was no favoritism there. I just got in the studio first and recorded it. And then I think Bruce recorded it. And then many years later, George Strait recorded it. So all that really matters is that eventually George Strait recorded it. It goes like this. Chills roll. here's a new song I wanted to do for y'all that I haven't recorded yet, but I plan to put on the next record that I make, which I'm trying to make happen. It's a tune I wrote with Betty Sue. It's called I'm Looking Forward to Looking Back. I'm looking forward to looking back, putting our pain in the distant past, a rosy glow on the way things were. Where we went wrong, we won't be sure. I'd like to forget the things I know. Each day I'll let a hard truth go. And when I stumble on a place we'd go, I'll drink a toast to you, the old so-and-so. I'll recall the nights we didn't dance. I'll think about how we'd laugh at the band. That hitch in your step when you'd spin me around. Your voice in my ear was the sweetest there is, then I can't wait to remember us and that second day. How long until we laugh about it? Someday I'll smile, but today I doubt it. We'll both forget the words that stung and just recollect that we were young. I'm looking forward to looking back. Thank you. This was on an EP I made for A&M Records that I got to record with Sunvolt. And this is another song that Bruce wrote. Bruce has got a couple versions of this too.
This one.
It's called He Don't Care About Me. A banjo on this one. Peace.
to numb. But drunk or blind, he gets there quicker the farther away I run.
Another one at Bruce Road. Somehow I got them all bunched together. I guess I thought they just went well together, naturally. Yeah. You ready over there, Scott? Okay.
Shedding out a tear when I turned out the light. No, I don't hurt like I used to. I didn't make all the knock on my door. Door in the room ain't empty anymore. So many got it tougher than I do. But I have not forgotten. I have not forgotten. I have not forgotten you.
When I first moved to Austin, I moved to Austin out of high school from the D.C. area. And I'm an Army brat, so I was from a lot of different places, but I moved there right out of high school. And one of the first people I discovered was Marcia Ball. I had never heard her before. And I became an instant fan. And I recorded this song of hers. I just thought it made a great country song. It's called Find Another Fool.
Goodbyes, but you still don't see the truth. All I did was try and make life better for you, but a woman just gets tired of being used. So go find another fool to love you. The world is full of girls like me. Find a fool to take care of you. Now that's a girl I'd like to see. Try, but you can't look her in the eye, and I know you. You'll find another fool. Now you say you wanna talk it over, and maybe I will change my mind, but you never heard. Time. So go find another fool to love you. The world is full of girls like me. Find a fool to take care of you. Now that's a girl I'd like to see. Tell her that you try, but you can't look her in the eye.
Thank you so much. All right, here's another one by my friend Damon Bramlett, who's one of my favorite songwriters. He's from Bangs, Texas. Lived in Austin for a little while. And me and Bruce and Charlie have all recorded some of his songs. This is one of his called Sweet Sundown. It's on my Translated from Love record.
How did you come be with such a tragic week? How on earth did you know what to say? And could you taste those tears on my trembling lips when you kissed my blues away?
Thank you so much. This is a song I wrote with John Leventhal, who is an incredible guitar player and producer, married to Roseanne Cash, and a Grammy-winning producer. And we wrote this song together, and I don't know, I guess I wasn't going in the studio anytime soon, but I wasn't really thinking much about it, and then somebody else called to see if they could record it, and I was like, no! I'm doing it. Like, suddenly got possessive of it, even though I'd completely forgotten about it. But it's on the last record I made at when I was in Nashville on MCA.
Get real. This ain't the way we used to feel. What we once earned, we have to steal. Conceal, it ain't real. Come on, we've been defending for so
two more songs for you. Thank you so much for being here and being so great. This is a song I've always introduced this as being a song written by my husband and my ex-husband, which I always thought qualified me to be a country singer. But now I get to say it was written by my ex-husband and my other ex-husband, which I think it's better, you guys.
You better look out, you're gonna get it. I'm getting worried for you, you got no idea what you're getting into. I've been alone for all these years, I know you've been hurting. This world can be hard on a boy like you. I ain't no reason to keep you feeling blue.
Joshua Blue and Scott Davis. Kelly Willis, thank y'all so much. Thank you.
Kelly Willis, everybody. I think you guys know that I never want to go home. Do y'all want to go home? Do y'all know the magic word? One more time.
Thank you so much, everybody. We do happen to know one more song. Y'all help me sing this one. It's got a lot of words. And I once learned this song as a prank for Bruce, because Bruce could do, if you requested any song, any country song, he knew all the words and could do it. And I can hardly even do songs that I wrote if you request them. So I went on like Twitter, and I was like, y'all, what is a really complicated song that it would be weird for me to have known all the words to? And they came up with this one, and I planted someone in the crowd to request it at one of our gigs. And then I was just like, yeah, I can do that one. Just did the whole song. It was one of my greatest moments. And then we recorded it and put it on one of our records. Little Harper Valley PTA, everybody.
I wanna tell you all a story about a Harper Valley widow who had a teenage daughter who attended Harper Valley Junior High. Well, her daughter came home one afternoon, she didn't even stop to play. And she said, Mom, I got a note here from the Harper Valley PTA. Well, the note said, Mrs. Johnson, you've been wearing your dresses way too high. And it's reported you've been drinking and running around with men and going wild. And we don't believe you ought to be bringing up your little girl this way. And it was signed by the secretary, Harper Valley PTA.
Later, I'd love to meet you. Thank you.
All right. Oh, what a beautiful night. Was it not, Kelly Willis and Sarah Johnson? Let's hear it for them. Woo! Kelly's going to head over to merch. You guys go and visit and get some product, right? Let's support these artists. We want to thank you for supporting the Levitt here tonight. I want to thank Texas Health, Arlington Memorial, Baylor Scott & White, Orthopedic and Spine Hospital out of Arlington, and all the sponsors that you guys saw listed on the screen earlier tonight. I want to thank you for coming out tonight. I want to thank you for every penny, dime, nickel, dollar that you put in the bucket, because that helps us pay these awesome artists that come on the Levitt stage. And you guys, we put out free music, but we make sure that we pay these artists because they are out. We want to support the music industry ecosystem, and your dollars sure help make that happen. All right, this is a quick update. For those of you that didn't hear earlier, next Thursday, North Texas Giving Day, celebrating all the nonprofits in North Texas, over 3,000. Well, Levitt is one of them. And you guys, we're competing in Arlington to be the best nonprofit for People's Choice. There are some cards back at the Info Center. There'll be a QR code on our Instagram. And if you're not following us on our e-newsletter, be sure and do that. All we need you to do is vote. If we win, we win $10,000 that goes to artists. Woohoo! That's big money. So pass it out, pass the card around, get everybody you know to vote, and let's bring that home to the Levitt Pavilion, Arlington, right? Yes. All right. Also, if you choose to make a dollar donation that day, if you could do it between 2 and 7, and then we're going to try to win some other money that day, because that's all about bringing it back home to here. All right, let's see. I think that's it. Tomorrow night, we have a great concert happening. Angela?
Big party tomorrow. You do not want to miss it. We have Martin Reina is opening up for Laura Denise y Los Brillantes. So it's going to be a Tejano night. We're going to have
a
vendors.
Dance party.
Dance, yes. We're going to dance. Latasha will be dancing over here if you want to see. So we're going to have vendors, food trucks, lemonade, everything. So tomorrow's going to be really fun.
Angela, what's that drink that...
Michelada.
Michelada.
Yeah.
Right? Woohoo! That's going to be great stuff. We want to thank you guys. If you haven't gotten your tickets next week for Mark Chestnut, you guys, it's Do Good Fest, Texas. I hear some hollering out there. We have Jack Ingram, Caitlin Butts, and Mark Chestnut. Register online. It will be a gated event. We will have full bar service on the street, and we're going to have a lot of fun. You can bring your chair, your blanket, and a couple of bottles of water, and be ready for Sam Houston High School? Their mariachi is going to kick it off. It's going to be a great night. Do Good Fest Texas, put on by National Life Group. And you guys, it is going to be one party. All next week, as a matter of fact, we have concerts here free Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday. So there's going to be a lot of free music in downtown Arlington at the Levitt. All right. What do you think? Be safe going home?
Yes. Be safe going home, and we'll see you tomorrow.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Good night.